Hey, what's up everyone? CommanderMani456 here today, doing a news update on Sonic Lost World for the Nintendo Wii U and 3DS. So as you all know, yesterday a new trailer was released, but today we have some new pictures. So the pictures that were released today are of a new zone that's going to be in Sonic Lost World, and it is heavily inspired off the Casino Night Zone from Sonic the Hedgehog 2 for the Sega Genesis. And as you can see right here, you know, in this first picture, Sonic's like on a pinball, you know, machine, to where you can see like the Sonic and Miles logos in the background. You see the bumpers and all. It looks very, very nice, and you know, has lots of references to the original, you know, Sonic the Hedgehog 2 game. And then as you can see in this second picture right here, this actually reminds me more of Sonic Heroes, like the Casino Park and Bingo Highway stages, because we kind of like see some cubes that are in the air, and they're, I don't know if they're bouncing on the stage or if they're actually rotating in the air, like some of the cubes that you actually saw in Sonic Heroes, but they were just red. So that was one thing that I kind of noticed right there. Then also in the third picture right here, you can kind of see Sonic running on the wall, and there's like this spinner thing. I don't know what it is, like if it's a roulette. I don't think it is. To be honest, I'm really not familiar with casinos, as I've, you know, never been to one, so don't expect me to know all this stuff. But as you can see right there, you can kind of see like the logos of, you know, Sonic and, you know, Dr. Robotnik right there, and Sonic's just doing parkour on the walls, and it's actually really cool. So that's the third picture right there, and then you can see the fourth picture, to where we actually see the egg. You know, we get to see the robots from Sonic Heroes actually return in this game, in the casino. And then we can also see, you know, the little, like, crab enemies, or, I can't recall what exactly they are, like, lobster enemies from Sonic the Hedgehog 2, to where they have their shields and all, and, you know, they can block your attacks. So you're actually, like, in this, you know, like, in these pictures, you can actually see a lot of references from Sonic the Hedgehog 2 and Sonic Heroes, which I think is actually really cool. And I'm noticing that there actually are a lot of references to previous Sonic games and Sonic Lost World, which is cool. And then you can kind of see, like, these tokens, where they kind of, like, have a star in the middle of them. Remind me of the Platinum Rings from Sonic and the Secret Rings, but not sure if that's actually going to be the case or not. Like, who knows, maybe they'll just be tokens that you can collect, or, I mean, we don't know yet, but just something that I noticed in the picture right there. So, that's it for the pictures for that were released today, but there were a couple of things I actually did want to talk about from the trailer that I missed yesterday, because a couple of people actually mentioned it and told me about it. But if you actually look in the trailer, when you see the, you know, the green female, you know, like, devil from the, like, the Deadly Six, you can actually see that that is the snow stage in the background, to where there are pine trees and there's snow covered over them. I forgot to actually mention it in the video last night, because I actually meant to, you know, talk about it, but completely forgot about that. And then also, if you actually look in the stage where Sonic is, you know, the Rhythm, yes, it's actually called the Rhythm Wisp, not the Beat Wisp. If you actually look at the Rhythm Wisp, you can see that in the background right there, you can see the King Boom Boo's, you know, little, like, cronies, his ghosts, that are flying around, you know, the stage. So, actually very similar to the Pyramid Cave stage from Sonic and Sonic Adventure 2 Battle. The thing is that these are actually not his typical, like, ghosts. These are the ghosts that you would find sometimes during the treasure hunting stages. So that's one thing that I actually did really miss right there in, you know, the footage. And also another thing that, Peroxade Zero told me yesterday, after we saw the trailer, was that, if you actually listen to the voice of the character from the Deadly Six who's talking during the trailer, you actually hear a little bit of Mephiles in his voice. It actually sounds very, very similar to Mephiles', you know, dark voice and all. So, who knows, maybe Dan Green actually voices, you know, the red, you know, character from the Deadly Six. Don't know yet, but, you know, just something that was actually pretty interesting that I thought, you know, was mentioned to me. So, big thanks to Peroxade for that. But, anyway, yeah, so just wanted to, you know, kind of point those things out that I did miss in the trailer yesterday, and show you all these new pictures. So, that does it for this video, so thank you all so much for watching. Please remember to comment, like, and subscribe. Stay tuned for more vids, walkthroughs, and updates. Hope you all enjoyed the video, and if you did, like I said, make sure to drop a like and a comment. It really helps out a ton, and, you know, always appreciate all the support and love to hear your opinions. But anyway, thanks again. See you all. Have a good day. Peace, Commander Minds.